The swings are stunning. But having said that, bonds are clearly a bad deal. There is no way we get out of this without serious monetary debasement. And so the notion that, you know, they're just not going to be money good. They can't be and won't be money good. Stocks, I believe, general equities are greatly overpriced, in my opinion. We could have a very extreme deflationary outcome for a brief period of time, which I think will then be countered by a policy response that will lead to an enormous inflationary outcome. And so, in my opinion, the two assets that you want to hold to address that are gold, because it deals with the deflationary outcome. Gold is cash that can't be printed. It is 5,000-year-old money. It can't be printed. So if we have massive deflation, massive risk off, people, when they're afraid, they buy gold. And so, in my view, everyone should have a little bit. Okay, just like everyone should have a little bit of Bitcoin. Bitcoin is the apex predator, best asset in the world, long-term going to crush gold, ultimately will flip it and so forth. However, I say long-term, not tomorrow. And so Bitcoin is your alpha, and gold is your, really, Bitcoin is your future stocks, and gold is what bonds used to be. Gold is a safe place to store capital.
Larry, you also told me about a gold conference you went to, a Goldberg conference, but everything's a bit different. I think you should explain that, because I thought that was super interesting.
I'm not sure what part of it. I was at the Zurich Gold Conference earlier this week, and a couple of questions have been asked a lot of me. I think it'll be interesting. I go to a lot of gold conferences. I speak a lot of gold conferences. You know I'm a gold guy. I believe in gold. And, you know, I think the two assets are complementary. First thing. Whenever I poll a gold conference, and generally speaking, they're older and not, you know, as tuned into technology as everybody in this room, I say, how many of you guys own Bitcoin? Half the hands go up. So half of them get it. And I view my role in this whole, you know, revolution is my job is to orange pill gold guys, because they already get the problem, kind of. And what they don't understand is that this is safe. They look at Sam Bankman-Fried, FTX, crypto, et cetera, all the bullshit, and they naturally conclude crypto's a fraud. I mean, without doing the work to really understand that what's been created here is immutable digital security that cannot be tampered with. And they don't understand that. I mean, it is digital gold. It's got better properties than gold. Once they come to understand that, then I think, okay, I got to hedge my bets. I'll have some of each. And then ultimately, I have friends who are total gold bugs who now have zero gold, and they're mad at me because they say, hey, there can only be one. Why don't you just have the one? And I say, because I don't like having 70% drawdowns on all of my net worth. So I balance the two out. I mean, I like having gold, because when Bitcoin gets cheap, I can sell gold to buy Bitcoin. But what was there anything else particular about the gold comments that you were looking for?
I thought the correlation between age and Bitcoin was interesting.
Well, yeah, very clearly. I mean, and also just the tone. I mean, to be honest with you, I'm there and it's dreary and it's depressing. And the people are between 60 and 90. And, you know, and they've all been waiting forever. And, you know, right? And it's kind of like, God damn it. I mean, one thing is sure. They've got a ton of privilege. They got all the money. They control the media outlets, all this shit. And they don't play by the rules. I mean, it's brutal the way they break the rules. I mean, black letter law, you know, they should have basically had to shut down Silicon Valley Bank. Dodd-Frank said all the depositors take a haircut. They lose money because they're in a stupid bank that did a stupid thing, right? But the fact of the matter is, when Bitcoin goes through 100, and then when Bitcoin goes through 1 million, you know, and more people, you know, are like the people in this room. I mean, I was at a Bitcoin conference in 2016, and there were like 50 people there, right? And now I go all over the world, and there are thousands of Bitcoiners. And I walk up, I mean, here's a good story. I'm in the hotel at the Gold Show in Zurich 2 days ago, and some guy about my age walks up, and he starts looking at me, he says, are you Lawrence Lepard? I said, yeah. Hi, how are you? Nice to meet you. Who are you? He says, oh, you know, I'm Joe Smith. I'm a captain for American Airlines. I just flew the 767 from Chicago to Zurich. You know, I'm overnighting here at this hotel. Me and all my buddies, we're huge gold and Bitcoin guys. And we love watching your podcast. Do you know Foss? Oh, yeah, I know Foss. You know, I mean, he's like dropping all these names. You know Jeff Booth? Yeah, I've met Jeff Booth. I mean, this is a 60-year-old Chicago-based American or United Airlines captain, right? I mean, the word is spreading. You know, people are getting it. They're definitely getting it.
Thank you for watching the interview highlights of Larry Lepard. If you